So, well, it has been 5 years I'm doing this YouTube thing now. Not on this channel, but on my main channel. And yeah, this year I restructured my whole channel and concept and environment. So I have a couple more channels now, which I hadn't had before. So today, to celebrate the whole thing, I'll give you another tour to the UNESCO World Heritage Site and the Kassel Wasserspiele. Yeah, I hope you enjoy it. And yeah, it's always a nice trip, and the kids walked all alone, so really happy with that. Here we are, and it's extremely full as far as I can tell, at least from the parking spaces and bus and everything. Oh yeah, first time this year. Let's enjoy it. Genau.
Ja, die ist da unten.
Der will end.
Da unten müssen wir hin.
Later.
Oder dahin, da am Schluss.
Ja, wir müssen erst was later get in the start.
Deswegen meine ich ja.
Hier ist der Aufmess drauf. What was already there at the first lake? What's it called there? Yeah, we're almost. We haven't been here since we moved a bit farther away, but. So, seems that the upper part is already disengaged after just 15 minutes, which is a bit early, I would say. But yeah, the whole thing is in renovation. It's since it was constructed, basically. The sound you're hearing, this are there are some water trumpets, which we'll show you down there. But the whole thing just works with water pressure. There's no. Nothing more than a couple of valves closing it off and engaging it. That's the whole mechanism. So, those are the trumpets which have been disengaged. Yeah, a bit too slow. We're missing everything. Yeah. Water is just starting to trickle and going slower. Do we be out? Everything full of fish here. I think white stuff is actually from algae and stuff, so it's not really chemical or anything. This view is absolutely stunning if the water is running. It's not at the moment, so. But I'll search a picture from here for you guys. So usually you can see Neptune. Okay, to it. Neptune and Pluto. I think Neptune down there. The whole thing is like white, cascading water and stuff. I live sort of closer here. Put on by jogging a couple of years ago. That waterfall up there is actually from another reservoir, which is called the. Oh, I forgot the name, but it's like the water from above is not enough, so they have the secondary reservoir which is going through this waterfall and this river here to ensure that there's enough water for the whole spectacle here. Actually, initially they wanted to have it running the whole year, but the water consumption is just too high, so they only have it now 3 times a week. No,
2 to 3 times.
Oh, keine nassen Hunde.
Actually, if you ever watch my virtual jog video, then I'm going along the reservoir for this waterfall. But I can't recall the name for the life of me. But it's called the Steinhöfer waterfall. So that lake up there, and that guy up there, just standing there, is actually giving water to the fountain in the at the end. So they have like, this is 30 meters up, and they funnel the water straight down, and then they have a 30 meter fountain on the end. So that's how that works. So the water's running there and below the road here, and then it's going to a place called Devil's Bridge. So yeah, this is where we are going. It's really wild. This is one of my absolutely favorite spots in the whole installation, and I'm not the only one, it seems. That's quite full. Yeah, but the roaring water here. And that bridge. Same thing from below. Yeah. That's the bridge. Yeah. We are really unlucky. We had the tour group rushing around, so now it's totally empty. But technically, it was absolutely full. It's absolutely stunning scenery here with the tree and the waterfall, and the Devil's Bridge is there behind the tree. So the next bridge, there we have absolutely stunning view with 3 or 4 waterfalls in junction. Not quite a bit of wide lens and wide angle, a bit below. We really get all the water. There's one particular view where can all get all the waterfalls in one line, and that's really fantastic and totally romantic. Yeah, I think this is about it. Yeah. You can see, one you cannot see, but quite a lot of water for. I think this is about it, yeah. Now we are going to the aqueduct. Yeah. And singing quite a lot here, so that's the downtime. Especially the first time, and I'm always doing it the first time. But the upper waterfall is already getting low on water, so we should move forward. All the water from the small waterfalls above is going into this aqueduct, which you cannot really see through the trees, but yeah, there's, and then it's for free falling here for I think about 20-30 meters. And smell is here as well, so yeah, Glad smell television never made it. That seems... sounds somewhat unspectacular, the fiance. Not sure what they're doing. But, yeah. But there it is. That is coming down. And the whole structure here, this is all artificial built, so there's nothing Roman here. They built it in a ruined style. See, it was always this way. The fountain has on the launch yet. Not more spectacular from there, I guess. Seems, everything seems a bit low in water this year, from my feeling. So, that would have been a nice place for a photo.
Maybe I can get motivated the kids to... come back here.
Getting sprayed by water right now. And that is the crowning final of the whole show. The fountain. I've mentioned before and all the time.
The
whole thing is just working on water pressure from the elevation, from the basis, from the red fat thing. Lucky it was not so windy today. Sometimes you get really wet here. Yeah, the aqueduct is already out of water, which is really early. Yeah, the car tomorrow falls before. Usually it has water for much longer. Actually a point where I never have been before. Yeah, thanks for guarding to the kids. Came here. Yeah, quite full. But not as full as it has been. Oh yeah, fountain is all out. All over for this week, or today, so I think they have another one on Sunday.